Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2082, Create Worksheets Macro. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Well, last week I was in Bloomington and Indianapolis, Indiana, doing two seminars there, and Pam from the Indy seminar said that she has this worksheet, and for each cell in column A, she wants to create a new worksheet, and then I made this part up, put the corresponding cell from column B in cell B1. Now, hey, currently, Pam noted that she is doing this in a very clever way to create all those worksheets, but it's still a hassle. She goes to Insert, Pivot Table, OK, and then from that new pivot table, she puts the account in the Filters area and then Data in the Values area like that. And then she goes to Options, Show Report Filter Pages, Show All Pages of Account. And bam, she gets the sheet names like she wants. Now, the data's in the wrong spot. She actually says at this point, she just goes through, groups everything, and then deletes those pivot tables like that. Okay, so that's the method she's using right now. And I want to see if I can do something faster of that worksheet. So the way we're going to do this is you're going to have to pre-select the sheets, pre-select the sheets. Also, hey, if you've never done macros before, do Alt-T for Tom, M for Mary, S for Sam, and change from the first choice to the second choice. Also, really, really important, your file, I guarantee it, is saved as XLSX. It will not work if you leave it that way. You have to do File, Save As, and choose this Excel Macro Enabled Workbook. That top one is the default, and that top one is the horrible file format that is not allowed to use macros. All right, so we're going to select that data, Alt F11. Opens up the VBA editor. If you've never done VBA before, you're going to get this ugly screen here. We're going to say Insert Module, and there's our new module. And you're going to type this code, the word sub, create sheets, open paren, close paren. As soon as you type that, they're going to put in end sub. But between the two of those, we're going to say for each cell in selection, we're going to set worksheet, and really we should probably do this, dim WS as worksheet. We're going to set worksheet equal to worksheets.add. Now, worksheets.add needs to know where we want to add it. And what I want to do is I just want to add this worksheet after the last worksheet in the workbook. So I'm going to say, how many worksheets do we have now? And here, let's just try this. Let's say debug.print worksheets.count. Right? And it says we have four. And let's go back to Excel and check that out. One, two, three, four. So we're going to be adding it after the fourth sheet. So after the wrap up, we should see a new worksheet, and that worksheet is where we're going to put the data for account 100. All right, now ws.name is equal to cell.value, and then we decided that we're going to take whatever is to the right of the account, the data, and we're going to take that data and put it in cell B1 of the brand new worksheet that we just created. So from the cell, right, for each cell, we're going to offset 0 rows, 1 column over and grab that value. All right, so we have our macro, file, close and return to Microsoft Excel, and then we'll press Alt F8, Alt F8, create sheets, and we'll go into options. Boy, what's going to be a good one? Control Shift W, W for worksheets. So I hold down Shift W in there, click OK, and we can click cancel. All right, select those cells, and then Control Shift W. Watch right here after wrap up. Bam, it adds them, and on each one, it got the data from each individual sheet. Cool, cool way to go. Being able to create many worksheets on the fly. And of course, it would work for far more than that. Let's do equal row times 2. Copy this down, 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 down. And select all of those. Oh, wait, we got to put some data over there. Just fill it with 2. All right. And then Control Shift W. Bam. Oh, I already used one. Sheet 49. But look, we were all the way up to the near the end, fast, fast way to create a lot of different worksheets on the fly. All right, topics in this episode. Pam from Indy wants to create a worksheet for each account number in column A. Currently, she is using the Show Report Filter Pages of Pivot Table. She's looking for a faster way. All right, so we're going to save the workbook as XLSM. We're going to go Alt-TMS and set to the second choice, not the first choice, Alt-F11. Now we're in VBA, Insert Module, type the code as shown, Alt-Q to return to Excel, Alt-F8, select the macro name and click Options, assign to Control-Shift-W. W. Hey, I want to thank Pam for being in my seminar in Indianapolis. We had a great time there, good group. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.